Welcome to Main Street Living. This program offers you the opportunity to participate in a worship service led by pastors and congregations of the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod from your surrounding area. On today's program,
Jesus was sent into this world to suffer and die so that he might bear fruit for us, that his death might bear fruit for us. Because by Jesus' death, when he suffered and died on the cross, all of our sins of thought, word, and deed were placed upon him. He received the death that we deserved to die. He did that for you and for me.
The service will begin after this opening hymn.
Good morning. I'm Pastor Lawson Short from St. Peter Lutheran Church in North Bend, and welcome to our service this morning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us then confess our sins to God our Father. Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we might delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In his mercy of our Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives the power to become the children of God and bestows upon them the Holy Spirit. May the Lord, who has begun this good work in us, bring it to completion on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Our first reading for this morning comes from Isaiah chapter 55, beginning at the first verse. Come, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters, and he who has no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk, without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen diligently to me and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Hear, that your soul may live. And I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. Behold, I have made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander for the peoples. Behold, you shall call a nation that you do not know, and a nation that did not know you shall run to you, because the Lord your God and of the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the righteous man his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord, that he may have compassion on him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our epistle for this morning comes from the book of Ephesians, the 5th chapter. Look carefully then how you walk, not as unwise, but as wise, making the best use of the time, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. And do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with all your heart, giving thanks always and for everything to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, submitting to one another out of reverence for Christ. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our gospel reading for today comes from the Gospel of Matthew, the 21st chapter, beginning at the 33rd verse. Jesus said, "Hear another parable. There was a master of a house who planted a vineyard and put a fence around it and dug a wine press in it and built a tower and leased it to tenants and went into another country. When the season for fruit drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to get his fruit. And the tenants took his servants and beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again, he sent other servants more than the first, and they did the same to them. Finally, he sent his son to them, saying, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, 'This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and have his inheritance.' And they took him and threw him out of the vineyard and killed him. When therefore the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants?" They said to him, "He will put those wretches to a miserable death and let out the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the fruits in their seasons." Jesus said to them, "Have you never read in the scriptures, 'The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone'? This was the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. Therefore I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people producing its fruits. And the one who falls on this stone will be broken to pieces, and when it falls on anyone, it will crush him." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We now confess our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Jesus Christ, her Lord. She is His true creation.
Grace, mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The text that will serve as the basis of our message for today comes from our gospel reading from Matthew chapter 21. In the beginning, the Master planted a garden. In the beginning, God, a builder, created all things. He created the cosmos, the sun, the moon, the stars, all simply to adorn his creation. He set the boundaries for the heavens, the sea, and the land. He built a fence around a garden. You see, he created the world, and in this world, he planted a garden, the most beautiful and best of gardens that could ever be found or even imagined. The best of the trees and vines and plants adorned it. It was adorned with fish and beautiful birds and all kinds of majestic beasts. In the middle of his creation, God created a paradise, something we can't even imagine today. And this garden, this paradise, he lent out to tenants, to a man named Adam, to a woman named Eve, to work the garden and to keep it. The master gave all of the fruit of the garden to them, save the fruit of one tree. Adam and Eve were not to eat of the tree that was in the middle of the garden, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, lest they die. Yet what did the tenants do? They disobeyed, taking the fruit that belonged to God for themselves, and so sin and death entered the world. But the master is a builder. And this time, later, he built something new. He built a beautiful vineyard. He took from the least of all the vineyards in the land, the least of all the peoples, and he made them into a great nation. And this vineyard was called Israel. He spared no expense to make this vineyard beautiful. In those days, you know, building a fence and putting a wine press in a vineyard and building a tower for protection and storage, to do that to a vineyard was to make it the best possible. I mean, kind of the same thing as like having a huge brand new shed on a farm and having all the tractors in the shed in John Deere green. See, the master, he made this vineyard. He made it very well. And again, just as before, he lent it out to tenants. He lent it out to the people of Israel to work it and keep it. All he asked from them was for some of the vineyard's fruits. Namely, the master asked Israel for the fruit of faithfulness to him. To those tenants, to the people of Israel, it was a good deal, a blessing. They couldn't have asked for a nicer vineyard, a nicer land, nor a more gracious master. But when the harvest time came and it was time for the master to reap, what did the master find? As we will see today, the master didn't find fruit, he didn't find faith, but instead he found violence. You see, our parable for today is all about the history of Israel. You see, our parable is teaching us about what happened from the times of King Solomon all the way to the time of Jesus. And from all the way to from the time of King Solomon to the time of Jesus, the leaders of Israel, the spiritual leaders of Israel, the kings of Israel were wicked. They didn't follow God nor listen to his words and ways. And the tents that God had sent to call his people Israel to repentance, what did the leaders of Israel do? They beat them, killed them. Jeremiah, the prophet, when he was sent to the people to call them to repentance, he was thrown into a pit. He was thrown into a pit. Isaiah, well, they sawed him in two. And John the Baptist, who was alive for a while during Jesus' day, he was beheaded. These prophets, they were rejected by the leaders of the people, especially the Pharisees, because the Pharisees did not bear fruit in keeping with repentance. You see, God's word, when it comes to us, God's word calls us to repentance. God's word shows us our sin, shows us that we have not loved God with all of our heart, soul, strength, and mind, nor loved our neighbors as ourselves. And because of that, the law, not only because it shows our sin, it also points us to our Savior. The law calls us to repent of our sins and not look to ourselves for any kind of righteousness, but instead to look to Jesus and His righteousness. In the days before Jesus was born, the people of the Old Testament looked to and trusted in the promise of a coming Savior. They trusted in the promise that the Master would send His Son amongst them. But even today in our text, as Jesus, the Master's Son, stood before them, the Pharisees rejected Him. You see, the way that fruit works in the Master's kingdom is fruit is what faith bears. The fruit of God's kingdom is the fruit which God's word works in us, which is faith. Healthy trees are those that hear the law, repent of their sin, and are made whole by forgiveness. Such trees bear fruit, good fruit, living lives of love toward God and one another. To them the kingdom of God is given. Jesus said to those Pharisees today in our text, "Therefore I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people producing its fruits." You see, those who will not hear their sin nor repent of it, what does Jesus say? The kingdom will be taken away. My friends, let us not be like that. Let us hear the word of God. For those who hear the word of God and repent of their sins are humbled by God's word. Those are trees that are made whole and ripe by the promise of Jesus Christ to come. They are those whom Jesus came to save. You see, we might wonder today as we, hear this parable. The Master doesn't seem to be very smart in a way. He sends some servants to get some fruit, and the tenants, well, they kill them. He sends more tenants, and they are killed. He sends His Son. Why would He send His Son if He knew that the tenants are already killed all of His servants? Why would He do such a thing? And the answer is actually quite simple. God our Father knew exactly what would happen when He sent His Son, Jesus Christ, into this world. He knew exactly what those wicked tenants would do to Him. He knew that those wicked tenants would take Him, beat Him, mock Him, treat Him shamefully, and put Him on a cross. But the Father still sent His Son, and He sent His Son because of His great love for you and for me. Jesus was sent into this world to suffer and die so that He might bear fruit for us, that His death might bear fruit for us, because by Jesus' death, when He suffered and died on the cross, all of our sins of thought, word, and deed were placed upon Him. He received the death that we deserved to die. He did that for you and for me, so that His death might bear fruit for us and within us. John would say, and we learn in the Gospel of John, that unless a seed is planted in the ground and dies, unless that happens, if that doesn't happen, no fruit will be born. Jesus went to the cross and grave for us so that He might rise again, paying for all of our sins, and offer and give to us the forgiveness of all of our sins. The one man, Jesus Christ, though sin came into the world through the one man, Adam, through the one man, Jesus Christ, all of our sins have been paid for. And through His death and resurrection, God, our Heavenly Father, was again laying a foundation to build something new. Through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, the Father was building something even greater than had ever come before. He was building His kingdom for us, the kingdom of His church. The stone which was Christ crucified, that stone which was rejected, is the rock upon which now the church is built. Upon Jesus alone, is the church built? Our lives are built. Every life of faith must be built upon Christ alone. Upon Jesus alone will we stand, because in Jesus alone do we have the forgiveness of sins and the promise of everlasting life. And my friends, God is building that church for you and for me. He brings us into His church through the gift of holy baptism, whereby all of our sins are washed away and we are built upon the foundation of the prophets and Jesus Himself, built up in a foundation for God, a house for God. In God's house, as we come to that house, as we, even at home, hear the Word of God, hear the fruit of Jesus' sacrifice, the fruit of His death and resurrection for us, we ourselves, God creates faith in us, faith that loves Him and that loves one another. And even in God's church, when we receive the fruit of Jesus' death on the cross, when we receive His body and blood and bread and wine, He strengthens our faith and gives us the forgiveness of sins so that we might bear fruit, loving God and loving one another. You see, to be a Christian is to be built upon Christ alone, upon Christ crucified, on Christ who is our chief cornerstone. And because of Christ's death and resurrection, God has been building something new. He builds His church. His church, unlike the Garden of Eden, will last forever. It's a kingdom that has no end. And by faith, received in baptism and through the grace of God, are we built on that chief cornerstone, which is Christ? And do we bear much fruit? Thanks be to God. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard and keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. We'll continue now our service by praying the prayer that our Lord taught us, the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with His favor and give to you His peace.
Take my
Thank you for viewing Main Street Living this morning. Our hope is that you have been blessed and encouraged by this presentation. If you're able to attend local services, I'd like to invite you to join us for worship at our congregation at St. Peter in North Bend. If you're in the North Bend area, our services are held each Sunday morning at 9 a.m. This broadcast is supported by the viewers like you, and their financial help allows this broadcast to continue. You can join us by sending a contribution of any amount to this address. More information about this program can be found at mainstreetliving.com, including links to other LCMS websites, congregation locations, and additional ways to donate. Thank you again for joining us today, and have a blessed week. We hope to see you again at this same time next Sunday on this station.